Sunday after Trinity, coming live from Grimsby Minster. A very warm welcome whether you are joining us live or watching this as a recorded service at some point in the future. The office continues with Psalm 39.
Thank you. The first reading is taken from the book of the prophet Jeremiah, chapter 7. The word that came to Jeremiah from the Lord, saying, "Stand in the gate of the Lord's house and proclaim there this word and say, Hear the word of the Lord, all ye of Judah, that enter in at these gates to worship the Lord. Thus saith the Lord of hosts, the God of Israel, amend your ways and your doings, and I will cause you to dwell in this place. Trust ye not in lying words, saying, The temple of the Lord, the temple of the Lord, the temple of the Lord are these. For if ye thoroughly amend your ways and your doings, if ye thoroughly execute judgment between a man and his neighbour, if ye oppress not the stranger, the fatherless and the widow, and shed not innocent blood in this place, neither walk after other gods to your hurt, then will I cause you to dwell in this place, in the land that I gave to your fathers, for ever and ever. Behold, ye trust in lying words that cannot profit. Will ye steal, murder, and commit adultery, and swear falsely, and burn incense unto Baal, and walk after other gods whom ye know not, and come and stand before me in this house, which is called by my name, and say, We are delivered to do all these abominations. Is this house, which is called by my name, become a den of robbers in your eyes? Behold, even I have seen it, saith the Lord. But go ye now unto my place, which was in Shiloh, where I set my name at the first, and see what I did to it for the wickedness of my people Israel. And now, because ye have done all these works, saith the Lord, and I spake unto you, rising up early and speaking, but ye heard not, and I called you, but ye answered not, therefore will I do unto this house, which is called by my name, wherein ye trust, and unto the place which I gave to you and to your fathers, as I have done to Shiloh. And I will cast you out of my sight, as I have cast out all your brethren, even the whole seed of Ephraim. Therefore, pray not thou for this people, neither lift up cry nor prayer for them, neither make intercession to me, for I will not hear thee." Here ends the first lesson.
Thank you.
The second reading is from the Epistle to the Romans, chapter 9. What shall we say then? Is there unrighteousness with God? God forbid. For he saith to Moses, I will have mercy on whom I will have mercy, and I will have compassion on whom I will have compassion. So then it is not of him that willeth, nor of him that runneth, but of God that showeth mercy. For the scripture saith unto Pharaoh, even for this same purpose have I raised thee up, that I might show my power in thee, and that my name might be declared throughout all the earth. Therefore hath he mercy on whom he will have mercy, and whom he will, he hardeneth. Thou wilt say then unto me, why doth he yet find fault? For who hath resisted his will? Nay, but, O man, who art thou that repliest against God? Shall the thing formed say to him that formed it, why hast thou made me thus? Hath not the potter power over the clay, of the same lump to make one vessel unto honour and another unto dishonour? What if God, willing to show his wrath and to make his power known, endured with much long suffering the vessels of wrath fitted to destruction, and that he might make known the riches of his glory on the vessels of mercy, which he had afore prepared unto glory? Even us, whom he hath called, not of the Jews only, but also of the Gentiles. As he saith also in Ozee, I will call them my people, which were not my people, and her beloved, which was not beloved. And it shall come to pass, that in the place where it was said unto them, ye are not my people, there shall they be called the children of the living God. Here ends the second reading.
Thank you.
This evening's anthem, variously attributed to John Hilton or to Richard Farrant, is Lord, for thy tender mercies' sake. If anyone is in Christ, there is a new creation. Everything old has passed away. See, everything has become new. In the diocesan Lincoln cycle of prayer, we pray for the Church of Nigeria. And across the diocese and parish today, we pray for horticulture, praying for all at the North East Lincolnshire Council, responsible for the parks and gardens, giving thanks for the work of Grimsby and Bloom, and praying for horticulture tutors, staff and students at Grimsby Institute. Grant that your church, O God, here and in every place, may offer a living worship to you in your glory, and a living witness to the world in its need. Through Jesus Christ, our Saviour, Amen. At this time of change in our parish, deanery and diocese, we pray for all involved, for those left hurt by the processes, as well as the hope that all may work together in new ways. We pray particularly for our clergy as discussions continue about their future ministry, praying for Catherine, for Pat, and for Jan as she continues her convalescence. God, our Redeemer, through your mercy you make all things new. We pray for a renewed outpouring of your Spirit on all that is new within our church, on all those entering into new ministries, on all those attempting initiatives, and on all those discovering new depths of spirituality within themselves, that, strengthened by your power and in the knowledge of your steadfastness, Christians everywhere may have the confidence to seek you in worship, to serve you in their lives, and to speak of you to others. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. We continue to pray for India, although no longer in the news, still in need of our prayers and practical support. Lord, you have taught us that in your Son the light shines in the darkness, and the darkness can never overcome it. Be with all those whose life is overshadowed by tragedy or dulled by hopelessness or resignation. Help them to see the light, however small or hidden away, in all that they experience, and help them to know the gentle but powerful support of your love. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Pray that this Minster Church may be here for all who need God's love, care and protection, that we may truly serve our community. For those who are sick, ill or grieving, for those rejected by society, for the homeless, the poor and the destitute, for those who are bullied, persecuted, fearful, for those who suffer discrimination because of disability, age, sexuality, faith, or for any other reason. God of creativity, by your inspiration you give us the power to rouse souls and change nations. Stir up in us that deep compassion for one another that makes us see all your children as our brothers and sisters. Teach us to fight the temptations of prejudice and pride with the strength of truth and openness, and bring about in our world that kingdom of peace and justice, which is the longing of the hearts of the poor. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Pray for those for whom this night will be their last on earth, for those whose year's mind falls at this time, thinking particularly of Stephen Jones, priest, and for the recently departed, thinking particularly of Chris and of Jacqueline. Rest eternal grant unto them, O Lord, and may light perpetual shine upon them. May they rest in peace. And a prayer of Saint Benedict. O gracious and holy Father, give us wisdom to perceive you, diligence to seek you, patience to wait for you, eyes to behold you, a heart to meditate upon you, and a life to proclaim you through the power of the Spirit of Jesus Christ our Lord. And may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Ghost be with us all, evermore.
Thank you. Our church's ministry and mission has never been more needed. Meeting online or in church for prayer services and fellowship, loving our neighbours by offering practical support to the vulnerable, and caring for our communities. The work of our church is reliant on people's generosity, and we are so grateful for all the gifts we receive. This generosity is a hallmark of a lived out faith and a testament to it. If you are able to give to us now, here's how you can help.